It's time to go large. Who is your best friend? Well, my best friend was a dog. This is a massive piece in tribute to my bestie, the late, the great, the Budmeister. Check this out. We went from an A2 regular size to an A1 bad boy size. What? Okay, you have seen the preview. You know what I'm drawing, so it's time to get drawn a bulldog. So my buddy, who was called Buddy, was also a bulldog. Most, you tend to find, which is a weird thing, that people who have bulldogs tend to call them something bigger than a B, but that's a by the by. So had decided beforehand to be drawing a massive picture. I'd normally keep it A2, but this particular one, I wanted to go really big. I wanted A1, which is obviously double the size of A2. So as you've seen, it's a big, big piece. With this initially, spray painted it. I thought that fitting in with where I wanted to put the picture up, because I'm actually drawing this picture for myself. There will be prints available, of course. But this particular one, I was drawing for myself, and in my living room, I had grays, I had yellows, I had blacks, whites. So I thought, right, background has to be that. Usual drill, as always, spray paint everywhere, and also get some on the page. So then when I had that done, let that dry. Now, because it was going up a size on paper, I actually had to get a thinner grade of paper, which was annoying to my usual type. So the paint took to it well, but it was it's a lot more paper-esque as opposed to card-esque, which the A2s were. Doesn't really affect it much, just obviously it's a bit more flimsy and not as robust. But paint went on well, paint dried, and then it came to the part of actually sketching my bud. So as always, I had to find a reference picture. Now, with my little puppy, I didn't have a problem getting a reference picture, to be honest. We took loads of photos of the dog, and yeah, they were all pretty good. Very photogenic dog. Bulldogs tend to have like massive creases, very distinct look, big, big chops on them, and sort of smaller like pinny eyes and massive head. So it's the characteristics of the dog lead it very much open to be photogenic, and then hence very much like easy to draw. Not easy to draw, I wouldn't say easy to draw, but very much distinct characteristics that if you get a couple of them right, then you're on to a winner. So we found a picture. It's actually a Christmas picture. He was wearing a Christmas jumper, but I've eliminated that on the actual finished piece because it wouldn't sort of sit right. As always then, we have the photo selected. With the photo selected, it was just a case then of drawing it on in pencil, just getting the sketch right. I decided to do that this time on A2, so it was two A3 cards stuck together. I was able to draw the actual image, and it was actually at that stage I knew it was going to be a good one, because the image, the actual sketch, was looking great. Looked very much like him. You always know you're on to a winner if you spend a lot of time looking at someone, or you know someone quite well, and you can look at that sketch and see that person in that, then you know you're on to a good one. With this particular one, even at the sketch stage, I was happy because I was able to look at the sketch and go, wow, that is Bud, that looks like that dog. So from there, it was a case of carbon paper on the back. I had to use, I should get bigger sheets, but I only had A4 sheets. So once again, it was makeshift. So I just mask and taped four sheets onto the back of this A2 image, sketch of him. Leaned heavy and was able to imprint that onto the sheet, the A1 sheet, the actual working sheet, which was spray painted. From there then, it just was a case of these bad boys. These seem to be the greatest tool ever. Now, I'm not trying to promote Posca as such, but I tend to use Posca. They've got a good range of colors. Those are all the colors you use for them. So that's about 10 colors there. All Posca pens, and you can get different shades in them, and you get different pen thickness. But what they are is they're an acrylic pen, so they're actually put paint on it. So if you're confident with pens, but not confident with brushes, Posca pens are great, because literally it is just a paint pen with a pen, or like a pen nib on a paint brush. Yeah, get it? So all I did was picked up the colors, and with Bud in particular, there was a lot of white. So obviously it's mostly white with then prominent brown fur around his eyes. With that, I put on the white first, laid down like a big layer, then put like deep, heavy black. I had initially the outline there, so just deep, heavy black into those areas. Then I wanted to lay down the browns, just to get the distinctive part on his face. I had pink, he had pink areas, so around his chops and around his creases, he would get like, sort of, you would see more skin color. So I was able to bring that in lightly with the pink. And then finally the highlights. There was a really, have a really cool pen, one second. Really cool, like light, it doesn't even look like a light brown, it's more of a peach, but it was perfect color for Bud because his highlights on his brown became more of like a peachy sort of skin color. So able to lay that down, and then finally took the black pen at the end and literally just added my sketch lines and sketch marks, which brought it to life completely. Let's have a look at the final piece and talk through it, boy. So here we have got the Buds. Now that his head was a bit smaller than that in real life, but yeah. So what have we got around his eyes? That's actually not a white, that's more of a skin color, but the dog's eyes anyway, was he tended to have like bloodshot eyes, so there's some pink going on in there. The pink's down here as well around his chops. His nose wasn't prominent like jet black, which you would see in a lot of dogs' noses. It was more sort of like a gray. I was able to pick up then just the browns, and then as I said, the highlight with the peaches. Came across at the end with a lot of black squiggles, as we call them. Black squiggles are my way of making areas dark, but having that artistic touch. So this drawing will never look realistic. It won't be a photograph, but it'll look very much like what the dog looked like. So I'll throw a couple of images up here so that you can actually see what the dog looked like. But as you can see, when I come close, the squiggle and scratch marks and stuff, that's just my style. That is what I'm trying to put on the drawing, and that's what makes this drawing extra special, because it is my little puppy drawn by Pops. Yeah. Hope you enjoyed that video. Give me a clue what you want for the next one. As always, I'm open for any suggestions. And yeah, as always, we will finish it in the same way. Hit that like, drop a comment, and make sure to subscribe. And if you know any bulldog lovers, send them this way, because they'll appreciate it. If you know a bulldog, you know a bulldog. Peace.